The Pinnacle and Inner Circle have their parlay.
This was the best thing on both shows, dude.
This is also awesome. So Tony explains Blood and Guts. It's War Games. He says, we are here tonight to do the coin toss to determine who has the man advantage. But then Sean Spears slaps the coin away. He says, we in the Pinnacle, we want the advantage because we were lured into this match. As opposed to you, Sammy Guevara, when was the last time you even had a match? He runs Sammy down for a while, and I will say this was actually a hell of a promo. I thought Sean Spears was an awesome promo. Sammy was also great. He notes Spears has been a failure in AEW. He's been a failure everywhere he's been. May 5th, he's going to fail again. You want the advantage of the match? Fine! You can have the advantage of the match, and then I'll start the match. I'll fight one of you, two of you, three of you. I don't even care. So FTR goes, and they say, we don't want this version of Santana and Ortiz, this soft, complacent version of Chris Jericho's lapdogs. Dax Harwood says this cage is his world. He ain't afraid to die. He notes that both Santana and Ortiz have children at home. And Santana and Ortiz start to get antsy. He says, Tuesday night before you fly down to Jacksonville for Blood and Guts, you grab your kids, you hug them, and you kiss them. And you get on one knee and you whisper that daddy ain't coming back home. And oh, Santana just about lost it at that point. Ortiz is barely able to hold him back, rein it in. You're going to have a gentleman here. Santana says, you're going to be locked in a cage with us. You ever been locked up? We have been. And we'll let our hands do the talking on May 5th. MJF takes his turn. He says, tonight they're here to act like gentlemen. He wants to thank Chris for everything he's done. Chris Jericho, you were the bridge for the lapsed fan. You brought everyone to AEW. But now, after all this time in the main event, you're under pressure. You're paranoid. You've got bloodshot eyes. I'm going to do you a favor. I'm going to take the burden of that crown off your head. I'll place it on my own. And the Pinnacle will replace the Inner Circle. When Blood and Guts is done, I'm looking down at your bloody, mangled body. I'll once again say thank you. And your spot will be mine. And then Chris Jericho goes. And it was last week or the week before, but he got like an A++ babyface promo. And this one was significantly better. He says, you said at 25, I was opening the card in WCW. That's true. I had also headlined arenas in Mexico and Japan and Germany. And all of that is why I'm here today. All of that taught me respect, taught me life lessons that put me at the top of this game. You want to earn my spot? Well, a good start to earning my spot is winning Blood and Guts. That's not going to happen. And he goes through the credentials of his team. This man, Jack Swagger, this man had my back when I was threatened with assassination in Abu Dhabi in 2012. I missed that book chapter.
That was a plane ride from hell.
I see. Hager had his back then. These lapdogs, you call them, Santana and Ortiz, they're wild animals. They've been fighting for me since day one. I brought Sammy into this Inner Circle personally, and he quit because of you, but I brought him back. He's never going to quit again. You'll have to kill us to make a surrender. It's going to be a summer of violence and pain for the Pinnacle. And May 5th, summer starts early for you. It was the best promo.
Every single person here, they really didn't let Hager and
Wardlow didn't speak. Tully didn't talk.
Tully didn't talk either. Actually, he should have talked. But, I mean, everybody that spoke, I mean, for the most part, it was one of the best promos they ever did.
Yeah. And, actually, it's true. That is true.
I mean, MJF always has awesome promos. I think this was just your average great MJF promo.
Exactly, yes.
They're all great. Mm-hmm. But like everybody else, Dax, probably his best promo in AEW, and Cash, probably his best promo in AEW, yep. And Sammy and Spears
for sure
was the best promo he's ever cut.
Yeah.
And I could not say this was the greatest Chris Jericho promo I ever heard like in his career, but I'm pretty sure this was the best promo he ever cut in AEW. This was a fucking home run by everybody involved, and I shouldn't say they needed it because they've actually done a great job every week. But as I've said a million times, like, it's next week already, so we needed a home run promo on this show.
The feud is starting with Blood and Guts,
we got one. So this was fantastic. If you're a big fan of these video clips here on YouTube, you're missing out on full length shows. Down there in the bottom right-hand side of the screen, click that join button, and when you sign up, you'll have full access to all of the shows that we've got up on YouTube, over 300 at current count. Wrestling Observer Live, The Bryan and Vinny Show, and Figure Four Daily with Filthy Tom Lawler and Lance Storm. Hit the join button, sign up today. You can also click subscribe, and you'll always be alerted as to when new shows and clips are available.